today we are going to discuss about transistor biasing techniques and stability, and its order code is 36203. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's talk about the working of this kit. So for that we have to do an experiment, that is to study the fixed bias circuit. So for that we have to make the connections. So we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this emitter, then we will connect these low beta transistor AC187 to this transistor. We will connect this collector end to this collector end, then we will connect this emitter end to this emitter end, then we will connect this base end to this base end. We should keep the O1 switch at off position, and we should keep this 470k knob at fully clockwise direction. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the power supply. So here we can see that the emitter reading is around 12.7 milliampere. So we have to adjust this at around 10 milliampere. So we will adjust it through this 470k knob. We will move it in anti-clockwise direction. And here we can see that the ammeter reading is now at 10.3 milliampere, and the voltmeter reading is around 2.26. So now we will not make any changes to this circuit. We will just switch off the power supply, and now we will shift this connections to this high beta transistor AC187. So now we will connect this collector end to this collector end, and this base end to this base end, and this emitter end to this emitter end. Now we will switch on the power supply. So here we can see that the value of emitter increases, as earlier it was 10 milliampere and now it was 12 milliampere. And we can see that the voltmeter reading reduces, as earlier it was around 2 volt and now it was 0.06. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the self bias or emitter bias circuit. So for that we have to do the connections. Firstly we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one, and now we will connect this low beta transistor AC187 to this emitter. We will connect this capacitor end to this capacitor end, then we will connect this emitter end to this emitter end, and we will connect this base end to this base end. So that is how the connection is done. We should keep this O1 switch at off position, and we should keep this 470k knob at fully clockwise direction. Now we will switch on the power supply. So here we can see that the ammeter reading is around 11.4 and the voltmeter reading is around 1.20. So we will set the ammeter reading at near 7 to 10 milliampere, and we will adjust this ammeter reading through this 470k knob. So now we can see that the ammeter reading is around 0.87 milliampere, and here the voltmeter reading is around 3.73 volt. Now we will not make any changes to this circuit. We will just switch off the power supply. Now we are going to shift these connections of low beta transistor AC187 to this high beta transistor AC187. We will connect this capacitor end to this one, then we will connect this emitter end to this one, then we will connect this base end to this one, and now we will switch on the power supply. So here we can see that the emitter reading changes and it increases. As earlier it was around 8 milliampere and now it was 11.4 milliampere, and we can see that the voltmeter reading is decreases. As earlier it was around 3.37 volt and now it was 1.21 volt. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the fixed bias circuit. So for that we have to make the connections. So we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, and we will connect this port to this one. And now we will connect this transistor to this low beta transistor AC187. So we will connect the collector end to this collector end, then we will connect this emitter end to this emitter end, then we will connect this base end to this base end. And here we are using this thermometer to measure the temperature. So firstly we should keep this oven switch at off position and this 470K knob at fully clockwise direction. Now we will switch on the power supply. And we will connect this CRO probe to these inputs. So now we have taken two wires from this output end and we will connect this to this CRO probe. And now we will switch on the CRO. Or you can use DSO also. So here we can see that the sine wave is showing on the display. We can adjust the amplitude of the sine wave through this 470K knob. And this sine wave structure to through this sine wave knob. Now we will switch on the oven. So now we have to observe the sine wave. After some time, this oven starts heating and temperature increases. Due to that, we can see that the sine wave starts clipping. And due to this clipping, we can see that the ends of the sine wave gets straight line. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the self bias or emitter bias circuit. So for that we have to do the connections. So firstly we will connect this end to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one. Now we are going to connect this transistor to this low beta transistor AC187. We will connect this collector end to this collector end, then we will connect this emitter end to this emitter end. Now we will connect this base end to this base end. So that is how the connection is done. Firstly, we should keep this oven switch at off position and this 470K knob at fully clockwise direction. Now we will connect this output port and this output port to the CRO probe. After that, we will switch on the power supply and we will switch on this DSO, or we can say CRO. Now we will adjust this 470K knob so that we can get a sine wave on the screen. So here we can see that on the display sine wave is there. We can adjust the sine wave through this sine wave knob. and the amplitude of this sine wave through this 470k knob. Now we will switch on the oven. So again, due to the heating, this sine wave gets clipped, and due to that the circular ends of this sine wave gets flat. So here we can see that the lower end of the sine waves gets flat. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that is how you can perform many other experiments that are mentioned in the manual. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, like, share and subscribe to our channel.